नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्।
Having prostrated to Narayana who came as Sri Krishna, having prostrated to Nara who came as the mighty archer Arjuna, having prostrated to Vagdevi Saraswati, by whose grace flows these words of this great epic, having prostrated to Vedavyasa, who is the compiler of this greatest of epics, Mahabharata may be told. Today we commence a very fascinating series of episodes of Mahabharata set in the Udyoga Parva of Mahabharata. The context is this: the Pandavas have completed 13 years of exile, 12 years of Vanavasa and 1 year incognito living, Agyatavasa. 13 years are over and they should rightfully get back their kingdom of Indraprastha from Duryodhana, but that is not coming because Duryodhana does not want to give that. That being so, war seems inevitable. And in that context, Dhritarashtra had sent Sanjaya to the camp of the Pandavas. Pandavas were in a place called Upaplavya. Krishna was there with them as well. This is supposed to be the modern Junagadh in Gujarat. So Sanjaya had come there with a wishy-washy message of Dhritarashtra. And then he had come back to the court of Dhritarashtra, having discussed with the Pandavas. Then follows two very, very key episodes of Mahabharata. One is called Vidura Niti, and then the great Vedanta treatise, Sanat Sujatiyam. And after that is a setting where Sanjaya in the morning comes to the court of Dhritarashtra and tells him that he has been to the court of the Pandavas, the camp, and what was the discussion there. This is the setting from where we start the great series of Krishna Dutam, where Krishna comes as a messenger to Hastinapura. Brief flashback will begin with the visit of Sanjaya to the camp of Pandavas, and we take off from there. Om Namo Bhagavate Sri Ramanaya.
Dhritarashtra said, Sanjaya, tell me, what do you think is the relative strength of Pandavas with respect to us? And Sanjaya had said, again and again I have been telling you, but I won't tell you alone now. Just for you and Duryodhana was there, I won't tell you. Call Maharshi Vyasa, your father, and call Gandhari. If I tell you alone, you will have only negative opinion. With them around, I will tell you again. So he called Gandhari and Vyasa. In brief, he told, you don't understand who Sri Krishna is. Kalachakram, Jagachakram, Yugachakram, Chakeshava. And it is he who has decided to relieve the burden of the earth and finish all of you. All of your sons, he is going to finish for Pandavas or Nimitta. He will use them. He tells them clearly, what do you think is Sri Krishna? It is he who creates, sustains and dissolves the world. Don't you know that? In front of Vyasa and Gandhari, he tells. And Vyasa tells Dhritarashtra, oh Dhritarashtra, remember that Krishna loves you very much. He loves you very much, which is why you have Sanjaya as a minister who can tell you like this. And Gandhari shouts at Duryodhana saying, Are Duratman, don't you understand? And finally, when Dhritarashtra says, listen, you seem to know Krishna, but I don't seem to understand that Krishna. Why? Then he tells because. He gives reasons why. And then he says, okay, so tell me the way to understand Sri Krishna. He says, there's only one way to understand Sri Krishna. You have to control your senses, you have to control your mind, you have to give up kapatam, you have to give up himsa, and you have to ever, ever, ever be steady in yourself, and that is the only way you can ever be able to understand Sri Krishna, is what Sanjaya tells Dhritarashtra. And then he sings the name, glory of Sri Krishna by singing his name. Each name, it has a significance. And then he gives the good news to Sri Dhritarashtra, say, oh Dhritarashtra, the Lord is doing anugraham to you and he is going to come here to your sabha. He has decided to come here to visit you. This is the boon that Dhritarashtra has got because of the night's visit of Sanatsojata. The Sadguru has come and has given the Atma Vidya, Brahma Vidya, he has explained to Dhritarashtra, and the next day Lord will come. But in a different context, he is saying, Sri Krishna is coming to your sabha, and Dhritarashtra says, blessed are the people who have got eyes, that they will be able to see the Lord when he comes here. I may not be able to see, but I will share the joy of the people who will see, who will hear him. And I know that whatever he says will be correct and auspicious. I also know that my son will not listen. But as far as I am concerned, I am surrendered to see Krishna. Naradipanam vidusham pradhanam indranujam tam sharanam prapadye. Naradipanam, the greatest of kings and the greatest of intellectuals, to that Indranujan, Krishnan Sharanam Prapadye. He says Indranujan here, you must note that the name refers to Vamana Avatara, who becomes Trivikrama and crushes Bali. That name he uses here, saying he is coming and I surrender to him, and that's where we start today. So back at Upaplavya Kshetram, where the Pandavas are there and Sri Krishna is there, now Krishna has, the next step has to be taken, and Vidushra approaches Sri Krishna and says, Ayam sakala samprapto mitranam mitravatsala nachatvadanyam pashyami yonapatsutaret. O Krishna, the time has come for a friend. You who are so dear to your friends and for whom friends are so dear, other than you, I know of no other means. I know of no other person who can help us cross this great difficulty that we are in. What is the difficulty? Yudhishthira now suddenly in front of him is able to see that the war is for real. There will be war. So he says, only you, O Bhagavan, can save us. And Krishna, who is like a right-hand man, 8-day camp to Yudhishthira, asking him, Kim Karomi, what can I do for you? What can I do for you? He tells Yudhishthira, I am Asmi Mahavahu, I am here. I am here. Tell me. Tell me, what do you think? What is your thought, O Yudhishthira? Karishyami hitat sarvam. I will do whatever you want. Whatever you tell me, I will do. Tell me what you want me to do. And he says, Yudhishthira recalls, he said, this is how Sanjaya came, and this is the message he brought from Dhritarashtra, telling Yudhishthira, what did Dhritarashtra's message was brought to Yudhishthira? Oh Yudhishthira, Duryodhana will not listen, you will listen. And why do you want the kingdom? You should go for salvation. Go back to the forest, do tapas. Better to live on bhiksha than to battle with your own. Sanjaya's message has been told. And it is clear that Dhritarashtra's sons are not moving from their position of greed. And we, O Krishna, you know well, have fulfilled the 12 years plus 1 year of condition without any mistake. We have done our part. It is my right, it is our right to get the Paitrika Dhanam, which is ours. We have to get it. Even if a person who is born in a good family, even if he is an elderly man, if he actually takes control of somebody else's wealth, he is an evil man. Lobha pragyanamahanti pragyahanti hata hriyam hrihrata badhate dharmam dharmam hanti hata shriyam shrihrata purusham hanti purushasya dhanam hata. He says greed. Greed kills vigya, vichara shakti. Man is not able to think clearly because of greed. And when that happens, Hri is killed. What is Hri? Hri is that attribute in you which stops you from doing something which is wrong. You know it is wrong, I should not do it, but something stops you from doing it. That is Hri. When your mind's intellectual discrimination goes, then Hri goes. Hri is destroyed. You end up doing the wrong thing. And when Hri is destroyed, then dharma is destroyed. And when dharma is destroyed, Shri is destroyed. Your glory is destroyed. Your wealth is destroyed. Your name is destroyed. And when that is destroyed, the man is destroyed. Because a man without Shri, without name, without wealth is as good as dead, says Yudhishthira. He should know. Because he has suffered this fate for 13 years, although he has been putting up a brave face, Yudhishthira for 13 years has lived as a pauper in the forest. He knows what it means to be walking around like a dead man, getting fired by Bhima and Draupadi and others. He says, Krishna, adana dinivartante nyatayah suhrudo dvijah. When a man becomes bankrupt, then his relations abandon him. His friends abandon him. And brahmanas will not visit him, saying, you have got davasham, shraddham, dysfunction. They will not come to a person's house, we have no money. They will abandon a person without money like a bird abandons a tree which has got no fruits or flowers or leaves. They fly away. Like that, people will abandon. Why? One's own family will abandon a man who has no money as if he is a dead body. And what happens, you know well, when a man goes bankrupt, some people go mad. Some people fall into the hands of their enemies. Some people do nicha karyam, become slaves, dasas, servants of others in order to live when they go bankrupt. One thing, Krishna, a person who is born into poverty is luckier than a person who is wealthy and goes bankrupt. Because a person who is born in poverty is okay, but a person who goes bankrupt. Granted, Krishna, that a person who goes bankrupt from being in a wealthy and a strong position usually goes bankrupt because of some mistake that he does, because of some dosham that he has. Granted. But it will not appear to him to be so. He will not think that it was his mistake. He will not think it is my dosham that was the cause for my downfall. He will not think so. He will shout at Vidhi. He will shout at fate. He will shout at God. He will shout at Indra and other devas. He will blame everybody except himself. Even if he knows Sakala Shastram, it will not be of use to him at that time. When a man is in poverty, dire poverty, he falls into the abyss of poverty, he becomes angry, he becomes irrational, he becomes cruel, his mind will think quickly of a shortcut to Narakam. This is the fate of people who fall into poverty. However, if one, even in these circumstances, is able to think straight and adhere to dharma, he does his duty, then he will be saved. And so I wonder, Sri Krishna, what is my dharma now? And I think that my dharma is this, that I should regain my paitrika sampatti. That is my dharma. I should regain that. But then, at what cost? I don't want war. I want to avoid war. What is the great thing and nobility in killing one's relations, one's elders, even one's enemies for that matter? What is the nobility in killing? Gurujanas, what to talk of? Oh Krishna. But then what is the option? My dharma seems to be that, to go to war. Kshatriya kshatriyam hanti matsyo matsyena jivati shvanam hanti dasharha pasya dharmo yathamatah. Oh Krishna, it seems to be the dharma of a kshatriya to kill a kshatriya. Just as a fish eats a fish, or a dog bites a dog, though that seems to be my dharma. War is a funny thing, Krishna. What can we say anything about certain in a war? One man may overcome an entire battalion one day. A coward may kill the most courageous and the most heroic person may one day be suddenly in a war, be killed by a damn coward. Tide in a war may suddenly turn. There is only one thing which is certain about a war. There is no real winner. Both sides loses. Yuddham is papam, Krishna. Yuddham is papam. And when does a yuddham ever get over, Krishna? Battle never gets over. Some fellow will survive. Some baby will survive. And now years later, people will be feeding it stories. This is what happened in your family. This is this thing, that thing. Stoke enmity in that kid. Make him seek revenge and one day again the damn thing will, he'll come. This is what happens.